get in and hold on. In the meantime, make use of that 44 and get us some cover. One launch site should just be up the path. Destroy the V1 and be careful.
The ability to precisely hit a long-range target with an explosive warhead was only a theory when the war started. The Allies experimented with radio-controlled drones, while the Japanese used human kamikazes to inflict damage in the Pacific. At their Peenemünde research lab, however, German scientists developed the V-1 flying bomb. Almost 30 feet long and powered by a pulse jet engine, thousands of these vengeance weapons were launched from sites all over Western Europe, inflicting heavy damage. After the war, captured V-1s were used by the United States to leapfrog into a new realm of guided missile development. Though progress would still have the occasional setback.
Time is short, so I'll be brief. With the successful breakout from Normandy by our troops, the Nazis are quickly falling back to their border. Hitler knows that France has been lost, and we've intercepted a communique ordering Dietrich von Choltitz, the general in charge of Paris, to burn the capital before the Allies get there. Apparently, though, Choltitz is having second thoughts about going down in history as the man who extinguished the City of Lights, and the Swedish Consul General has stepped in to broker a ceasefire. Unfortunately, we can't be sure all the junior officers will go along with disobeying a direct order from the Führer, and there are reports of explosives being distributed to key locations around the city. Paris has survived for over 4 years under Nazi occupation. It would be horrible for it to be destroyed now, on the eve of its liberation. It's time for you to go home, Manon. Good luck.